All right, we are back for more action here on the Power Hour from the Disney MGM Studios. Tony Schiavone and Terry Taylor back in the saddle, so to speak. As
hey, wait a minute. How come Shanghai Pierce has that mask on, Tony? He was on mask last week. We all saw it.
Well, I know why.
Okay.
Because the match was signed to unmask, and he took the mask off, but we didn't say he couldn't put it back on.
Well, now that we know who he is, why did he put it back on? You know the answer to everything.
We only saw him a fleeting moment last week.
Thank goodness.
And as we take a look at Scott Sandlin on your left, Brian Armstrong on your right, and I guess he wants to put it back on and pretend it never happened, at least for this matchup. So here we go. There's the bell, Terry.
Pretty thin, but okay, Tony.
Well, it's good as anything else. Tex Lasinger and Shanghai Pierce. And I tell you what, old Shanghai is not a bad-looking guy. He's not as ugly as Tex.
He's not my type, but yeah, he's okay-looking. Have you noticed how much better they've been wrestling the last 3 or 4 weeks?
Yeah, I do.
They have really gelled as a tag team, and I think they may make a run at the Nasty Boys, if the Nasty Boys can survive against they can survive against Cactus and Max Payne.
Elbow in the back of the neck. They bring a brutal style to the ring, just like the Nasty Boys, just like Cactus Jack and Max Payne.
Wow.
Big elbow.
Have you seen a wrestling hold yet, Tony? Anywhere in the building?
Well, an elbow drop is not a hold, but it is a clean wrestling move.
Well, Tex comes in, gives him a kick to the side of the head, drops 3 stiff elbows on him. This is exactly the style that the Nasty Boys try to do, and I see a lot of guys in WCW liking that style. There you go, right back to the basics for wrestling, and he's got a bigger man down after taking a pretty good thrashing. Brian Armstrong's a tough kid. Second-generation wrestler. His dad's Bob Armstrong, brother of Brad. These Armstrongs are double tough, and they love wrestling here in WCW.
There are 4 Armstrong boys who are in wrestling right now, and Brian is a veteran, as he was over at Desert Storm.
Yeah, when you say 4 boys, no wonder Bob's still wrestling if he's got 4 sons.
A tag, and here we go.
Scott Sandlin came in and got bushwhacked.
Whoa, and a big double clothesline, or double lariat, if you will, a cover by Shanghai.
See, there's reasons that those moves are illegal. It's because they could hurt somebody so badly. Scott Sandlin doesn't know where he is, and they could have beat him, and they chose not to. They're just going to inflict more punishment. Poor Scott Sandlin's about 100 pounds lighter than his opponents. That's hard. That's a hard thing, even if you are quick and with great technique. These guys are 300 pounds each, the Texans. And I mean, they are double tough.
Pounding Scott Sandlin down to the mat. Take a look at this.
Man.
That'll put a lot of pressure on that back and the vertebrae.
Yeah, what he did is he drove him into the mat like a hammer driving a nail. This right here, what it does is it drains the blood into the head, which makes you dizzy anyway. And I think Scott Sandlin was dizzy to start with to sign this match. And then here they go, kicking him in the head again. Ugh, they are brutalizing this young man. Whoa! What's the name of that, Tony?
Well, that's an inverted side salto right there is what that is.
I was going to say a belly flopper, but yours sounds better, I guess. Poor Scott Sandlin. I mean, this, I like watching great wrestling, but this kid is just outgunned here. Oh, backwards DDT. 300 pounds with the elbow on the face.
Wow.
Very impressive.
Tremendous win and a tremendous team. He may have the mask back on, but he is still Shanghai Pierce, and he's awesome. They are awesome. But the fans don't appreciate it at all. But
neither does Scott Sandlin.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
These guys came out here like 2 human Vegematics and just dissected this young man. That move should be illegal. They took him down, reverse DDT, hard elbow drop. These guys look like championship contenders.
All right, standing by with comments, Ricky Steamboat.